A former federal MP, a former police officer, and the founder of Queensland's first school for kids with autism. It's a three-horse mayoral race in Redland, and with no incumbent, the contest is fierce.
Future-proofing the city is actually really important.
Our core platform is around good governance, so integrity.
Jobs. Fighting native title.
So fierce, the Electoral Commission has issued a warning. Seven News has obtained the letter sent to Redland candidates after a significant volume of complaints from voters and political hopefuls, behaviour causing the Commission concern for electoral integrity and potentially constituting offences warranting police involvement. Accusations of stalking, intimidation. Seven News also told two people were injured during pre-polling at Cleveland.
My goodness, did we not think it was going to be as intense as it has been, and it's really disappointing.
The Electoral Commission scolding pointed out despite 77 local government contests happening across the state, there was no other council with the same level of complaints, bitterness or bad behaviour as Redlands.
I don't think it reflects well on our city. I don't think it reflects well on our candidates.
Dirty tactics on the Sunshine Coast too. Core flutes defaced as the region decides its new mayor. The incumbent isn't recontesting. Testing in Noosa either. Today, Logan's mayor held his last council meeting.
One of the big things I want to do is change Logan's reputation.
These mayoral hopefuls are promising to address Logan's sky-high rates.
The budget and the rates and the way the rates are rising in the city are outrageous.
At least four South East councils are guaranteed a fresh face at the top, while more than a dozen Queensland mayors will get re-elected unopposed.
And Jacqueline Robson joins us now. And Jackie, there are calls to ban how-to-vote cards.
Sharon, local candidates say this will really take the heat out of polling booths, eliminating the competition to get those cards into the hands of voters. During COVID, in-person distribution of election material was paused, but Queensland's Electoral Commission says they no longer have the power to do that. A spokesperson said they've been deploying extra staff, bringing in security, and is encouraging those worried about public safety to contact police. Candidates say they want Redlands in the spotlight for the right reasons. It's not off to a good start.
All right, Jackie, thank you.